Hello and welcome to another episode of Goa 365 Story Behind the Story. We had this, we've been discussing this tourism and the tourism policy in the last episode, and we've not even reached halfway, so we thought we will do another episode of this. So welcome guys, welcome Nilesh, welcome Manoj, welcome Ralph. Now in the last time, Nilesh, you were talking about Gram Sabhas and this committee, so I will start with you. Please, Nilesh.
Our worry is it should not become like any other government organization which are already there. Here, there private play participation is being called for in this tourism board. So when we are talking about the private people joining from the industry, those are all our industry experts, or maybe from the industry people who are part of the different association. So the idea is, you know, the inputs which are given by the industry will be to the point which can be implemented. So that should be, you know, proper structure should be in place, and you know, the proper roles has to be defined. Like you have, like in the tourism board, there will be two major things which are going to be. One is the marketing part and one is infrastructure part. So okay, of course all these things in the board, whatever is defined, it will be implemented by the government. So but the proper role for the marketing purpose, because as a board we interested into the marketing part of it. Of course, infrastructure is the key for sustainable tourism. But the marketing part, where, you know, which market to address, which market to we should focus more in the looking into the inputs received from the members. So what happens, people as an industry, we are on the ground and we can sense each market with the competition what is happening. So that input is very much required, and that has to be taken in total when we are implementing marketing policies. Similarly, infrastructure. Now, infrastructure, there has to be, role has to be defined. When we are talking about tourism infrastructure, it has to be related to tourism. It cannot be, you know, because I want some something to be illuminated X, Y, Z, the tourism budget is transferred there. Or in particular, road has to be illuminated, tourism budget is transferred. As you know, everybody knows that tourism gives a major revenue to the government. So, as a stakeholder, we also contribute in the way of taxes and license fees. So we have, because one of the statements have also been made that, you know, the everything government is spending, then why there should be more representation to the industry. So on that, basically what we are looking at is that we as an industry, we are, as Ralph Bab and even Manoj has said, that, you know, to see that economy of Goa grows, in turn we will be able to grow ourselves, employ more people and generate more income, and have overall the benefit the welfare of the state. So we are part of giving contribution for form of taxes and different way. It may be fixed charges, or it may be from the form of GST, or maybe from the excise fee. So looking into that, I think we are contributing, I think, a big amount. So total after 14,000 crores, which is a Goa layout, I think tourism directly must be contributing more than 2,000 crores. Plus, besides indirectly, must be another a few thousand crores. So looking into that, I think we have to be in forefront, and the private players has to be involved by the government, and the pressure, looking into expertise of the each industry, the people who are driving. There are many people in the industry who are driving the for last decades together. So those experts' views has to be taken, and it has to be implemented. Basically, the what we right now, what is happening, I tell you, as a TTAG, we are on the different boards, on the government boards. What we see is, in everything is, you know, agenda, everything has been given, and you, at the most, you can have a dissent to it. So don't have a decision making if you want to object to something. At the most, it will be minuted, but it is not way forward. Here, what we are looking is collectively, with all industry minds coming together, and government hear our voice, which will benefit them overall.
Yeah. Now, thanks, Nilesh. Now, I would like to go to Manoj on next on this. Just one point, I would just like you, maybe you can, now what Nilesh says is that besides the rest, just one point that I, you know, brought. Agenda. Now, the agenda is already given. Agenda, there is no input from industry, so that to frame the agenda of that particular meeting specifically, you can just address it somewhere in between, Manoj.
Yeah. I think, Glenn, what we need to see is not to criticize the whole thing in totality.
Okay.
Because I have gone through the tourism policy in detail. There are certain very good things. But what is important is that government should use the teeth to implement it, as what Nilesh said just now, and not just use it as a policy on paper. I'll give you one example. See, there is no business why government should be in business. So this is what is practically implemented in this policy, because we have this GTDC now, which is there for the last about 30-40 years functioning. Now, if as per this policy, in the next 10 years, GTDC will be out of business. It is supposed to be getting out of all the hotels, taxis, sightseeing tours, river cruises, everything, which is a very, very positive sign, because there is no reason why a government should be in the business.
Correct.
So from that point of view, I feel it, I wouldn't say that the whole thing is drafted badly. It is drafted well. But as what Nilesh and Ralph says, what is very important is that the industry should be given the tooth to get it implemented and not use our representatives just as rubber stamp. Because as what Nilesh said just now, what happens is all the agendas are pre-decided and when it comes for the meeting. So what will the industry experts or any expert give you inputs if you have already decided on certain things? Just a case in point, what Ralph said, when you're forming such a good tourism policy and giving all the powers to the tourism board, what was the necessity to float the tender just 48 hours before this to appoint a PR agency for marketing Goa?
Absolutely.
So, you know, it smells of a foul play. So, which is something which is not giving confidence to the industry. Next, I will tell you, we need to be very, very sure and clear as to what we want. Goa is Goa. Goa, people will not come to Goa to see Singapore or Italy. Because let us not try to make Goa into a Italy or a Singapore. If they want to see Singapore, they'll go to Singapore.
Absolutely.
If they want to go see Italy, they'll go to Italy. So,
absolutely,
let us not try to compare ourselves. We have a lot of good things within ourselves. Whether it's a beach tourism, hinterland tourism, or whatever. We have enough things, so we need to do that and create the infrastructure which is required and sustainable within the environment that we operate our tourism industry in. So from that point of view, what I feel is the tourism policy is drafted well, relatively well. Of course, a few things could have been a little better, but what is important is that government should implement it in true spirit of it and not leave it on paper like any of the other policies which are always formed.
Yeah, thanks, Manoj. Now, Ralph, I would like to bring you onto this. Now, implementation is a point that has been, is a trend. Last couple of times when I've spoken to Nilesh, even initially when we spoke to Manoj, implementation has always been the, as they say, the bear in a shop or an elephant in a shop. So, Ralph, I would like you to speak on this a little bit, and then you can add on to what Manoj has said or whatever you feel about the policy itself. Ralph.
Okay. Yes, implementation is important. Now, a powerful board has been created, and this board is going to, has a mandate. It's going to take a lot of load out or from the Department of Tourism, like marketing, like positioning of Goa, maybe into some infrastructure selection, the new activities, choosing the new activities in tourism which are suitable for Goa. All this will be taken over by the board. Now, the policy speaks that the Department of Tourism is the implementing body and will remain so. So now they can concentrate on implementation. They have to use all their energy, their time on implementation of the policies of various do's and don'ts and rules and regulations that are in place.
Okay.
What happens is, seasons are short. Suppose there are an infringement. Before the action is taken, inspection is taken, you call for a letter, you give a reply, the season is over. So the things just fall apart. Now, if the time and energy of the Department of Tourism is diverted or concentrated only on implementation, we have hopes that things will be better, provided they do the job of implementation and they do not spread themselves into other board matters, which the board will take care of itself. Bye.
Yeah. Okay, thanks. Glenn, now, I would like to bring Nilesh on this
Glenn,
issue of... There is one thing. Now, as far as this board is concerned, as far as this policy is concerned, as far as the tourism board is concerned, basically this tourism board is what is going to make the policy, right? It's based on the your master plan and based on whatever criteria. So now, how would industry like to come in? Like, for example, this is of course hypothetical, this is a wish list sort of. How would industry like to come in to frame the agenda, to sort out the issues before it is put up? What would you like to do, Nilesh?
Glenn, what we are looking at is, like, you know, when we'll have industrial experts in the committee, so it will be a joint process. Basically, you know, like what happens, the each market, like if it is international market, then we require the inputs from the charter operators, you know, what are the markets which are giving the competition to them in their different market. So basically, to drive the agenda, main thing it is to be clear that, you know, the industry people will come together and prioritize the things which require. But the challenge will going to be basically whenever suggestions are given, so it has to be taken in the right spirit and for the implementation purpose. Now what happens is, in many of these things, you know, the reservations were that, you know, if it has a private member, should not be overpowered by the government board members. Reason being, then the full purpose of this thing will be, see, one thing government should realize that industry is not in for having a war on the in the board.
Absolutely.
Meetings or in
nobody
the
is
board.
It's not the intention.
It is for their benefit of the stakeholders put together. So, you know, basically it will boil down to that. So basically, there are so many, you know, they also have their own concern. They have KPMG full time guiding them on the different infrastructure projects and different areas of tourism. So specifically, with us also, if we are going to have a good vertical where we'll have a small committees which will, you know, give us the inputs and, you know, but try to implement the things which are required. And main thing what happened with this board and with this, there has to be immediate reaction to particular thing. Here what happens, the cycle is so long. Like if markets are like right now, suppose we have COVID, which is of course more stretched, but there are certain times, certain markets, there are small disturbances there because of maybe a civil war there or something. Then we should be identify those markets to divert the tourists from the areas which we are going there. Now this is thing is possible if, you know, the private players are involved and get that expertise on the daily basis. Now this has to be taken by the government spirit, and, you know, we have to start to implementing, you know, how to work our marketing plan to address those markets particularly. This is just one small example which I can think of.
No, but Nilesh, I want to go back slightly. I'm talking about agenda setting. Now, when an agenda has to be set. Manoj, you want to come in before that?
I can come in on the same point. You know what? One of the very important positions in this board is of the CEO.
Yeah.
There is a CEO who has to be appointed. What is very important is that this CEO should be a professional appointee and not a political appointee.
Absolutely.
Which is very important. So your agendas can be driven, rightly framed with technical expertise and help if you have a professional CEO manning things and not somebody's right-hand man acting as a CEO. Number one. Number two, I don't think we need to also appoint an IAS officer or somebody of that cadre as a CEO. We need professionals. Because I'll give you an example. Look at the case of our Goa IPB, Investment Promotion Board. Now there are three CEOs changed within a year. Now it cannot work this way. For the success of this policy to be implemented, we need to have a professional CEO who has to be paid well and who has to be a political figure who will put all these agenda items in place by taking the feedback from the industry as well as looking at whatever the government priorities are. So CEO's appointment has to be apolitical,
crux.
Which we would insist that this is the crux of this whole thing.
Yeah, Manoj, wait, I will go to you before I go back to Nilesh, because instead of asking him that, I'll start with you. Now, you spoke about, and we had also spoken about this. Now, for example, for any meeting, there has to be an agenda. So, now the agenda now, like most government meetings that I know of and I've seen, the agenda is already set. I don't know, some bureaucrat sits and he types out, I don't know from where then. So now, how is this? Like, what would you all want before the agenda is set? Isn't it important that some sort of consultation happens with the industry, or is it already happening?
No, what is important, Glenn, is that the industry should also give the feedback to this to the board through the CEO that these are the points that should be included in the
agenda. That's what I'm saying. Yes, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, so we need to give the feedback before a meeting. Of course, currently there is such things are not there. Such entities are not there. But what should happen is that the industry bodies should give the agenda points in advance so that they can be incorporated in the agenda for discussion at the board meeting. Now, if we don't give, then we cannot blame the government.
Absolutely.
Nilesh, because they cannot dream what we want.
Yeah, Nilesh, I would like to bring in Nilesh on this. Now, Nilesh, on the same agenda thing, now the solution is what, Manoj, would you like to add a little bit to this agenda, how agendas are to be set, and then I would like to go on to one point that we had spoken about briefly earlier about consultants. But right now, Nilesh, I want about the agenda, how agendas
basically from on industry. The agenda front, now the basic issues everyone are aware of, you know, what are the challenges which we are facing. So it is, you know, consultants with everyone, it is possible to set the agenda and to get the basic things right which are requirement of a day. It may be on the infrastructure front or it may be on the marketing front. And I feel it is a doable. In Goa itself, we have a classic example. We have one of the best cardio unit in the GMC, which is the government body. How it succeeded? That model itself we can replicate. They bought best of experts of doctors to head those things and from the private thing, and it's been headed and it's working quite well. So similarly, it has to be like Manoj said, you see the promotion board which is happening, or even for that matter, imagine Panjim. You see the fate of the CEO, because if it's from experts, from the people who are going to implement, then it's going to not going to work the way we want it. So we have to have, you know, correct guys from the industry to implement things and the set the agenda and get the basic things right to start with. I think go ahead for the board or the future part. If it is implemented in the right, it will go in the right direction. If it, you know, the right agenda has been set to start with, to get the basic things right.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Thanks, Nilesh. Now I would like to go to Ralph on this. Now, Ralph. Now I want to know some positives, like some specific positives, and that are there in this policy, and like what you feel and what could and should be done to implement them. Now, let's, guys, in this last few minutes, let's go in for some solutions that you all need from the policy that the board has to take forward. Yeah, Ralph.
Yeah, first, as far as the constitution is concerned, it should consist of representatives from the government, from the trade, and professionals with proven track record. Professionals in such a way that they know how to handle this huge industry. And because we don't have that right now, we have to employ consultants. If we have people of good talent, there will not be need of any consultants. One problem will be solved. Secondly, we are trying to go to hinterland. Yes, it's a welcome move. We have to expose Goa, but it's God's creation. It's very lovely. We have to tread very softly. Development does not mean concretization. It means preservation and conservation of whatever there is there. The village culture, the villages, the natural beauty, homestays instead of beach hotels. Encourage homestays where people can actually experience Goa living with a family in the villages. Okay. Goa is a small place. You have big constructions, that's why there'll be nobody going. Infrastructure, basic infrastructure is required. Take the people by rivers, by the boats.
Mm. Absolutely.
Created Goa to be seen from the rivers. So okay. It will be a lovely ride. Very humble looking jetties, maybe of bamboo or wood, is good enough. And they have a full total Goan experience. So we don't need to go overboard, spend a lot of money and all. All that has to be spent on the marketing which the policy has suggested. Select your niche, select your markets, focus and target them in the domestic as well as in international areas, and then you will see the dividends coming in. So it is very important that we take, there are a lot of good things as Manoj said, very good things, but a board is required, a professional and a focused board is required to make sure that all the positives are taken care of, that the things are implemented in a proper way. And at the end, if this is followed, you'll have an all-inclusive tourism that started in Goa in 70s, when infrastructure was created, even the rooms by the local people for the hippies to live in. The food was provided by them. This is before hotels came to Goa, before restaurants came to Goa. The same thing can happen in hinterland, and I think this should happen.
Yes. Now, I would like to bring in Manoj, just to add on this, some solutions, some positives, some the way forward, so as to say, Manoj.
Yes, Glenn, you know, as I said, I would like to repeat, the Goa Tourism Policy 2020 is drafted very well, but what is important is as to that we need to get it implemented. One very important point is that availability of funds. The funds for this board will come through budgetary provisions. So it is important that the Goa government in its annual budgets allocates sufficient funds at the disposal of the board. Otherwise, having the best of the board, best of the people, with best of plans is of no use if there is going to be no money. So the state government has to allocate funds to the board and leave it at the wisdom of the board to spend it in the best way in the interest of the tourism industry. And that is the reason, since this board is going to have the powers to spend the money, that is all the more reason why all of us are repeating again and again that it should be left at a very, very high involvement of industry and experts, and should not be left only to political or at bureaucracy level to be very heavy in this board. Because for us, it's very important that this money is rightly spent so that we get the benefit to improve the industry in the state of Goa. Because please understand that this is the only hope that we have in Goa in the near future, that I can see, not only to improve the state's economy, but also to take care of about 40% of our population who are brinking, who are on the brinks of huge trouble which they are facing currently. So I hope the government will, better sense will prevail, they will implement the policy and listen to us and see that proper tooth are given to this board with industry participation.
Yeah. Nilesh, any last words, especially this is the goose that's laying golden eggs, whether we are, it's going to continue or we are going to decide. Last words, Nilesh.
In fact, Ralbab and Manoj have covered up many, most of the points on this.
Yes.
But the main thing is what we are looking at, that the CEO has to have a powers to implement certain things. Like we have to learn from our mistakes. If you see the image in Panjim, it is a total failure. At least as in Panjimite, I can see, you know, I'm not able to see the things which are, you know, actually concrete, the things which are there. I believe there was a lot of challenge to them. You know, the word of CEO was not listened by the bureaucrats down the line. Now, certain things, these things should not happen. So basically, the proper thing given to the CEO. And once it is, like once CEO says something, it has to be implemented by all government babus as per the requirement. Because, and it is for the benefit of the state. So it should not be, you know, like CEO is not an honorary post, or it is, he is a powerful body. And when he comments something, it has to be, it's after dictatorial level, it has to be implemented by all the government bodies. Which is not happening till now, if you see in the Imagine Panjim or for other
smart
posts,
city, yes.
There.
Yes.
Smart city. So, looking into that aspect, of course, in smart city, they have done good job in many areas. I'm not listening, but what I'm saying, the challenge which was faced by the CEO,
I would like to see that. I don't quite agree with you that we'll have another discussion on that. But still,
the government thing to that. So, but then it does not make any sense having a CEO.
Yeah, Nilesh, no, I'm sorry I interrupted you on that, but the smart city, will have another discussion on that. But I don't think that anything has happened in Panjim. Sorry, I am also a Ponjay guy. Sorry.
Yeah, not into it, but just the example, you know, that CEO should have powers. What I'm trying to say is, and this power should to be such that it has to be listened right from top to the bottom, has to abide by his.
Yes, I agree with you on that point. Yeah, guys, we've run out of time. It's been a very nice two episodes that we've spoken on. Thanks a lot, Ralph, Manoj, Nilesh. Thanks very, very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
And keep watching Goa 365.
Thank you.